सर
मैं उनको बोला कल जाके सर को
सीएम जी आस्ते पड़े तो देरी हो
ठीक है
और स्टार्ट करो।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर, माय टीचर्स एंड माय कलीग्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट द केस ऑफ स्टोक्स एडम सिंड्रोम। माय पेशेंट मिस संध्या सेन, 63 इयर्स, फीमेल्स ऑफ केजीपी, presented with complaints of decreased urine output since 3 days, fever since 2 days, and altered sensorium, irrelevant talk, Stokes Adams syndrome 2 times, and vomiting 3-4 times since 1 day. Patient was apparently ordered 3 days back when she noticed decreased urine output and frequency. The urine output was approximately 450 to 500 ml per day. It was not associated with hematuria, dysuria, and abdominal pain. Patient also complains of fever since two days, which was mild grade intermittent and not associated with chills and rigors. Patient also complains of Stokes-Adams syndrome 2 times since 1 day. One occur 1 hour before presenting in casualty, and one episode occur in casualty itself. It was revived and patient immediately shifted to ICCU. Patient also complains of altered sensorium and irrelevant talk since 1 day, and vomiting 3-4 times since 1 day. Vomiting contains ingested food material. There was no history of chest pain, palpitation, swelling of feet, weakness in any limb, or PND, orthopnea, angina on exertion, or dyspnea on exertion, dysphagia, diplopia. There was no history of hematemesis, melena, abdominal pain, joint pain, rashes, hematuria, breathlessness, cough, or hemoptysis. Patient was recently detected diabetic and hypertensive and was on put on Telma H 40 mg once daily from private physician. There is no past history of TB or similar complaints. Diet is mixed and patient was non-smoker and non-alcoholic. There is no history of diabetes, hypertension, tuberculosis or any similar complaints in any family member. Menopause occurred 20 years back. Patient was conscious. On examination, patient was conscious, disoriented, averagely built and nourished. There was no pallor icterus, JVP was not raised, and no cyanosis, clubbing, lymphadenopathy or edema. Pulse was 44 per minute, regular, normal volume and tension, and no radioradial or radiofemoral decay. BP was 130 by 72 mm of mercury in right arm supine position. Temperature was above febrile and respiratory rate was around 18 per minute, which was abdominal palsy. Respiratory system, bilateral vesicular breath sounds are heard, no added sounds are heard. On GI system examination, upper abdomen was soft, non-tender, there is no organomegaly and peristaltic sounds are heard. Cardiovascular system examination, cardiac S1, S2 heard normally and no murmur or pericardial drop is heard. Heart rate was 44 per minute. On CNS examination, patient was conscious, disoriented, pupils were bilaterally reacting to light, normal, speech, there is irrelevant talk present, cranial nerves are normal, motor system and sensory system are found to be normal, plantar bilateral flexure, and there was no necrosis. To summarize this case, a 63 years female of KGP presented with decreased urine output, altered sensorium, irrelevant talk, loss of consciousness, that means Stokes-Adams syndrome, vomiting 3-4 times since 3 to 4 days with recent history of diabetes and hypertension without any history of shortness of breath, chest pain, limb weakness. Examination revealed bradycardia and disorientation without any other significant neurological finding. Then we done ECG of this patient and which showed there is a nodal rhythm loss of, there is no P wave, and rate is around 56 per minute, 54 per minute. There is no P wave. So in ventricular rhythm. Now coming to investigations, hemoglobin was 10.4 grams per deciliter and total count was 13,800 with neutrophils 84. Others are normal and we done cardiac markers which were all negative. TROPC is negative, CK-MB is around 14 and LDH 220, SGOT is 27, international units per liter. Then we did urine, since the patient is diabetic, we done urine ketone bodies which was found trace positive. Then we did, when the patient came to casualty, we just done a CPS which was came around 423 milligram percent. And this investigation came meanwhile in half an hour to 2 hours. RBS is 383, urea is 57, and creatinine 1.7, sodium was found to be 103, and potassium is 6.8. Chloride is 85 mg equivalent per liter, and all calcium phosphorus within normal limit, and LFT is within normal limit. Uric acid is slightly limited. And the serology was found to be negative. Blood CS and urine CS revealed no growth. That report came after 4-5 days. This X-ray is very normal limits. USG abdomen showed kidneys. Right kidney is 10.3 and left kidney is 10.6, which is normal. CMV is maintained and rest is within normal limits. ECO we found LV size normal and good LV function, and no RWMA, and LVEF is around 73%. So problems in this patient is, first is the most severe problem is junctional rhythm with idioventricular rhythm due to hyperkalemia. Second is hyperkalemia, hyponatremia, sepsis, and hyperglycemia.
The patient